Denny Hodge here with ProMMAnow.com, speaking with Dave PeeWee Herman. How you doing today, brother?
Doing pretty good.
Just wanted to ask you real quick, I know you had a fight here recently in May with Sokaju over in the United Arabs. How did you think that went? I know it ended kind of in controversy for you as far as the disqualification goes, but just speak your mind on that real quick.
I was, I was a little upset about the DQ, but it was my fault. But other than that, I was real happy with the fight. It was the first time I've ever actually fought anyone that I went out and felt comfortable on my feet. Usually in any kind of a grappling situation, like I'm like, whatever, it's no big deal. But on my feet, I've always kind of been a little nervous. I don't know if you guys have noticed, maybe you have. I like fight with my hands down and my chin up. But for the most part, my chin was down and my hands were up. There were a couple instances where I was like, I screwed up again. But I felt comfortable, and I think my striking is actually starting to progress a little.
Okay, so coming into that fight, everybody knows Sokaju's background as a kickboxer. He's got real strong leg kicks. Was it your plan to stand up, or was you coming into the fight looking to take the fight to the ground and see what you could do there?
No, my plan was to stand. Just stand and see what happened. I figured he'd eventually probably try to take me down. He did it two or three times, I think, unsuccessfully. I was comfortable. It went real well. I was winning. Like I'm thinking, fight's over, he's done, and I'm going in for the kill. And DQ'd.
Okay, so I know there's no videos of the fight. So like you were saying, you was actually winning the fight. I heard from Ed Clay that he was actually really totally in control of the fight when the illegal knee happened.
Yeah, I was.
Okay, so did you not know that he was down, or just you was just caught up in the moment trying to finish him off when you connected?
No, I knew he was down. It didn't even occur in my head, like, this is illegal. Like, I never even thought it. In Japan, it's legal, and that's like where my last fight was. It was in Japan that I had been training for, and I was planning on trying to go back again here soon. And then that fell through, and I ended up getting this one. And it didn't even cross my mind. This is illegal until the ref stopped it. I was like, oh man. But it happens.
So you talking about like possibly going back and fighting with Sengoku again?
Yeah, hopefully. I'm open to fight any and everywhere.
Yeah, that being said, is that a challenge in your mind as a mixed martial artist with the different rules fighting in the United States versus Japan?
A little bit. Like you get used to one, and then you're like, if you're in the fight and you're like, wait, am I allowed to do this or not? I don't know.
Sometimes you hesitate.
Yeah. I think there should be no rules.
No rules at all. Just like the old days.
Yeah.
So what have you been up to since coming back from overseas there?
Just visiting family, hanging out, still training. Went to Jiu-Jitsu Worlds, also got DQ'd.
Wow, what happened there?
They claim I slammed the guy, but it really wasn't much of a slam. Again, what are you going to do? Can't argue with the referee.
Absolutely. So you about to get back full force, focus on training again for what's coming next?
Yeah, hopefully get something else here again soon, and I'll be ready to go.
So what do you feel like? I know you spoke earlier about your stand-up improving and you feel really comfortable on your feet. Where do you feel like your strengths are right now as far as your total fight game?
Well, I like to think everywhere. Like I said, my stand-up's actually improving. Before I even started training, everyone was like, he's a striker, he wins by knockout. But anybody that actually knows what they're doing is like, man, that's terrible. But I'm actually starting to get a little technique in striking, and hopefully I can keep progressing with that. I still got a ways to go. I just finally felt comfortable. Doesn't mean I'm actually good at it yet.
Right, so, what about the ground side?
Hopefully soon. The ground, I've always felt pretty comfortable on the ground. Jiu-Jitsu is kind of progressing a little. I've actually been wearing a gi and competed in gi a couple times. And every match in a gi I've competed in, except for the one I got DQ'd, I won.
Right. So do you prefer gi or no gi?
I actually used to really hate the gi, but I think I'm starting to like it. I think I'd rather compete Jiu-Jitsu in a gi than without one.
Give you some more tools.
It's just easier. So there's, yeah.
Kind of slows the game down and well, not necessarily slows it down, but gives you a lot more tools and stuff to grab onto and choke people.
Yeah, I don't know. I just like it.
A lot more control.
It seems a lot easier and quicker once you learn it. Before, I was like, man, I hate this thing. Get it off me.
Yeah. I know how that is.
I like it now.
Hey, I don't know how much you could talk about the Bellator situation with the contract and all that, but do you have anything to say about that?
Well, I don't really know what to say. Just have court. They were pretty much in a breach of contract, and I was like, no, I followed the contract and let them know, and they were just like, no. Reminds me of the time I tried to break up with my girlfriend. We're dating, and I'm like, this relationship just isn't working. We're done. We're not going out anymore. And she was like, we're not done. We're still going out. And I was like, man, what do I say to that?
Should have took her to court too then.
I know, but if only I could.
So where will we see Dave Herman in the next year? Is it a possibility we can see you in Strikeforce or the UFC? 16-2 overall. I know a lot of fans have been talking about wanting to see you on the bigger shows and big cages, the Octagon even.
Yeah, it's very possible. Like I said, I'm open for anything. I'd happily fight anywhere. Basically, whoever gives me an opportunity and whoever wants me the most.
Sounds great, Dave. Well, I appreciate your time. Thanks for talking to us.
Hey, see this t-shirt?
Yeah, what's the story behind the t-shirt?
It's the official Dave Herman tuxedo t-shirt. And got a nice little photo on the back.
Nice.
And it's for sale on AmericanMayhem.com. So check it out if you want one. I've worn it out several times to the bar, drinking. Most of the crowd liked it, and a couple laughs, but overall positive.
All right, good to go, man. Thanks again for your time.
Yep, thank you.